Hey guys, welcome back to another Ycoder video. So today in this video, I'm going to show you how to code Fibonacci series using SwiftUI in Xcode. So yeah, let's get started. Before that, people may wonder, what is this Fibonacci series? So it's nothing but the sum of the last two digits of the sequence. It gets added up for the entire time. It's just never ending sequence. For example, let me take the beginning number as 0, then put the step as 1. The last two digits are 0 and 1. That's gonna be 1 again. Same way, 1 plus 1 is gonna be 2. 2 plus 1 is gonna be 3. And did you notice I'm just adding the last two digits? So 2 plus 3 is gonna be 5. 5 plus 3, 8. Then 13, 21 just goes. It's just never ending. Yeah, so I'm gonna show you how to code this in Xcode. Get started with the playground. Next, it's gonna be Fibonacci sequence. So it should be in iOS and blank also. Now let's get rid of the var string. It may be import foundation. Yeah. So we're gonna declare a function named Fibonacci sequence. So inside that I'm gonna write starting value. It's gonna be start. And it's gonna be an integer. Same steps. It's also gonna be an integer. And the last thing, maximum. So we need two curly brackets. Okay. Now we're gonna declare a variable named series. We'll name it sequence. So that's gonna be equal to start, then start plus steps. So people may wonder why I need to declare the start steps and the maximum value. So basically, not everyone wants to start their series from 0. Maybe they want it to start from 20, 30, 40, I mean 100,000. That's the reason I'm giving it a starting value. Now, steps means the next number of the beginning number. For example, if I take my beginning number as 40, and what should be my next number? So steps, if you put the steps as 5, so it's gonna be 40 plus 5. So 45 is gonna be my second number and the series continues. 45 plus 40 is gonna be 95. No, sorry, it's gonna be 85. And the maximum represent like till where to where. For example, I want from 40 all the Fibonacci series from 40 to 100, 40 to 1000. So this represents that. Now what we're gonna do is declare a while. Now we're gonna create a while loop. It's gonna be sequence brackets, and in that it's gonna be sequence dot count minus 1. That's gonna be the last number, should be greater than or equal to the maximum number. Now again, to curly brackets. Now sequence dot sizes, we're gonna put sequence dot count minus 2 plus, I'm gonna copy paste this, let's change it to minus 1. And before that. Sorry. So that I need to put these in brackets. Not the curly bracket, the normal bracket. And sequence. Same goes here also. Just delete this out. Oh, I'm gonna copy this right here. And we'll change to minus one. So this is the equation or the expression which represents the Fibonacci series. Like it's F21 minus 2 plus F12 minus 1. Unexpected. Oh yeah, so should be here. Okay. We're all set. Now we're gonna return the while loop. Unexpected non void return value in void function. Yeah, I'm so sorry I missed out one thing here. It's gonna be minus greater than two brackets gonna be in. So yeah. Now we are all set. We need to assign a value, right? So I'm gonna put the first one, Fibonacci sequence starting value, those things. Yeah, I'm gonna give a starting value. Let's put it as 30 instead. So the next number should be maybe 35. So I'll put steps as 5. The maximum number should be 200. Yeah. I'll pull this up and this to a side. So this is the place where you can see the series, and this is the debugging place for the console. Yeah, so we got it. So the Fibonacci series between 30 and 200 is gonna be 30, 35, 65, 100, 165, and 265. So basically, you can assign any value, like 60,000. It's taking some time. We got it. If you want the entire sequence, you can click this, yeah, small rectangular box and pull this down. You can get this sequence here also. Put this 10,000. I put crown. I need to pull it more, yeah. So 60, 65, 125, 119, and just goes on. Till the maximum value. So you may wonder, the maximum value is 10,000, but we have assigned the maximum value as 10,000, but here it's showing 14,700. That's because at this place we have put the maximum value can be greater than or equal to than the value we have assigned. So 14,700 is the greatest number after 10,000. Thank you for watching the entire video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and please do like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.